that actually the really beautiful thing about Kashmir is not the place, but the people. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Rahul Gandhi. Now, we would like to start the most awaited session, yes, the question answer session. Umran, please start the session.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hang on. Well, wow, it's indeed a moment which has, you know, filled me with all sorts of ebullience and effervescence. Just look at them. I am being the student of management. I was always surrounded with the books, with the cases of the dignitaries like this. Now today, it just, I can see life. It's indeed a moment which has filled me with all sorts of elan. It's a moment, historical moment. Never before in the history of Kashmir, we had academicians like this. We had academic program like this. It's only today, and I want to express my sincere thanks to Mr. Rahul Gandhi and Professor Talat Ahmed for this. Well, since for the businessman, the time is money, we got to make every moment over here quite effective and efficient. Even if you look the way they sit around there, that's kind of a learning for us. Just look at the way they sit, look at the way they drink the water. That's the way you got to learn in the corporate. Now, in order to make, let me make some rules clear. We have two mics. One, I will be holding it. Second will be with a basel. We won't be giving you the mic. You won't ask a question from a mic alternate. It will be an alternative basis. And we will make our level best to reach the every nook and the corner of the convocation hall. I know you all are excited, but let's do it in a very proper way. So can I have a hands for the first question, please? Let's start with the lady over there.
Respected dignitaries, a very good morning to all of you. My name is Shabrina Siddiqui and I'm from MBA Department, University of Kashmir. So, as in the introduction, it has been already mentioned, we the students of JNK State, we are really talented. We have got potential in us. And whenever we have got the chance to show that potential, we have done it with our dedication, with our enthusiasm. But what we are lacking are the large-scale opportunities. You know, we don't get chance to really work for the large corporate sector, the business tycoons. So my humble request for you is, rather I welcome you, to take some initiatives for the youth over here so that they won't even get the chance to work for you, but to work with you. And apart from that, we have got that spark, you know. The spark needs to be ignited. And I would like you people to take the bold step to ignite that spark, which will not act as a platform for the development of the state, but in turn, the development of our country. So I would like you people to answer.
Anybody can take this and So firstly, let me say that coming here brings back a flood of memories, because I've spent all my childhood summers here. So it's beautiful to be in Kashmir, and it's beautiful to be meeting with all of you. I'd like to just say very quickly that I work with a very small NGO in Bombay, and incidentally that was started by 5 Kashmiri youth. It's called Miracle Couriers, and it employs mute and deaf to deliver couriers. And just having worked with those 5 boys and girls from Kashmir gives me a sense of the kind of commitment, the kind of passion, and the kind of organizational ability that they have. And I think that these are qualities that none of us on this dais doubt about Kashmiri youth. I think that if I speak for my own group, we're looking at growing 1.5 times in the next 4 years. And one of our biggest challenges is to have talent. And there is no reason why we would not encourage Kashmiri talent to come and work with us. I think whether it's talent from Maharashtra or Gujarat or Kashmir, I think it's irrelevant. I think what we're looking for is talent. What we're looking for is people with merit and education. And I think that we would very much welcome Kashmiri youth to India, to corporate India, to come and work with us and work shoulder and shoulder with shoulder to shoulder with other youth from other parts of your country.
Like Kumar said, it's been a great pleasure to be here, particularly under the initiative taken by Mr. Rahul Gandhi, which has in fact ignited that fire that you speak of. Let me just say that we can all be here and exchange pleasantries. But perhaps what I would like to initiate is to say that we can do something discreet. And what I'd like to offer is that when I return back to Bombay, the Tata Group will establish a program with the university of having internship in a controlled manner that will give the Kashmiri youths a chance to apply, to work side by side with us. And we have found most internships end up in permanent employment. And permanent employment leads to word of mouth addition with companies, their associate companies, their affiliate companies. And so what I would like to do is to make that commitment that I will interact with you, sir, in putting together an internship program and perhaps with it some stipends that could become the basis on which we can break the barrier that I think industry, I have to say, has not looked consciously, not unconsciously, but consciously at what wealth of intellect and capability exists in Kashmir. So we need to correct that. And I think having been here today gives us that opportunity. And I think we need to rise to that occasion. And as Mr. Gandhi said, savor the capability of the people. It's a lovely place, but we have great intellect in the human capital that exists in this state. So I think I would like to make that offer.
Thank you very much. I'm representing the financial sector in India, all aspects of the financial sector, banks, insurance, asset management, housing finance, and we are having a massive program of growth in the Kashmir, in Jammu and Kashmir. We are one of the largest employers in Kashmir in our bank. We have about 60 branches, 41, and all this in the last 2.5 years. Most of the growth has come in the last 2.5 years. Similarly, what I'm willing to commit is that in our entire group, we will send our HR people for internship and recruitment to your university every year. I'm willing to give that commitment. And you know, in HDFC Bank, we have a certification program. Across the country, the problem is not a Kashmir issue, it's an Indian issue, that graduates are unable to get employment because they lack a little bit of training. What you learn in the university is not enough to automatically get a job. You need a little bit of specialization. So we have started in Kashmir certification job that a graduate can come and get a certificate in 6 months on all aspects of banking, all aspects of how a bank is run, how all the systems are in place. With that certification, I'll also see if we can increase the number of students we can take, because apart from employment in HDFC, the whole banking sector. And I would also like to say that the Indian Bank Association, the IBA, which represents banking in India, this year I think the banks are going to hire 100,000 people across the country. Insurance industry is going to hire 100,000 people across the country. So why can't we get the IBA and the insurance agencies, the parent body, to come and have a dialogue with your university and see what best we can do? So ma'am, your question about not working for us in Kashmir, but working with us and for us in other parts of the India can be taken care of.